Nature's great destroyer. This active volcano is one of the many sites that the University of Manchester's Professor Chris Jackson has got up close with. Whether it's in this BBC documentary or being the first black man to give a Christmas lecture at the Royal Institution, being someone others can look up to is part of the territory as one of the world's leading geologists.
I just try and make the best of the opportunities I've got to put forward a positive image of a black working class, you know, a black originally working class man from the East Midlands. You know, that's all I can do. And then hope with that, that some people, whether they're black or not, right, they could be a white working class person from the East Midlands who identifies in me something that inspires them and wants them to come into geoscience and stay in geoscience, let's say.
Professor Jackson's the co-author of a new study which shows he's a rare specimen when it comes to BAME academics and students in earth sciences.
Everyone in the geosciences has known that racial equality isn't great. But I think it was shocking to realise that as a trio of subjects, you know, these subjects that typically traditionally are grouped as the geosciences or the earth sciences, that we are the bottom.
For generations of student geoscientists, Alderley Edge has been a frequent field trip destination. But scratch beneath the surface of the field itself, and it's not so much who's on those trips as who isn't. Just under 20% of 18 to 24-year-olds in the UK class themselves as black, Asian or minority ethnic. When you go to university and look at undergraduate level, that figure's around 15% doing a physical science like physics or chemistry. The bottom three, however, are geology, which is just under 10%, and the figures are even lower for environmental science and physical geography.
There is a diversity crisis in our subject, and you know, that there are very few of us about. There are some, but it is quite hard, and you have to certainly go out looking for each other. You know, that's a network outside their own university, because there's just so few of us about.
It's been based on a foundation of being used to explore, and often it's been exploration as part of the colonial empire. There's still modern links with mining. The case recently in Australia of the indigenous site being destroyed by a mining company. There are still these things happening. And I think we can't teach geoscience without recognizing this with our students and discussing some of these issues.
Acknowledging a subject's past can help it become more accessible, as can outreach work, like that of Black to Nature.
But it isn't just diversity for the sake of diversity. Because in terms of academia, at least, if you're not reaching out to people and engaging with more people, you're also missing out on some amazing students that could be achieving so, so much. And I think that that's the bit that people forget when you're talking about racism and you're talking about engagement. It's not just for the benefit of the people, it is for the benefit of the institution as well.
And scientists from a wider range of backgrounds may be just what's needed in the midst of a climate crisis.
Geoscience has a really critical role to play in addressing a lot of social and environmental problems globally, water security, geohazard mitigation. There's a load of things which are happening both in our back gardens in the UK, as well as on the other side of the planet, and geoscientists are really well positioned to tackle that. But to tackle it appropriately, we need to have diversity in the population of scientists doing the work and communicating the work to the public.
So the argument from the rock experts is we can all benefit if the study of a prehistoric age is brought into the modern era. Sanny Rudravajhala, Quays News.